Hello, Treasured Visitor. Rebecca here from www.rebeccastreasures.com, and welcome to part 6, the final part of the Otis Giraffe crochet along. Today we will crochet the giraffe's head from the top down. As we do so, we'll continue with the spot attachment and we'll also join all the facial features, including the horns, ears, eyes, and muzzle. So if you have yet to complete parts 2, 5A, 5B, 5C, and 5D, please do so first before continuing with this tutorial. At the end of this video, we'll join the head and the body together, and your giraffe will be complete. Are you ready? Let's begin! Supplies needed to finish the Otis Giraffe Cowl include the main color yarn for your project, your crochet hook, stitch markers, scissors, a tapestry or yarn needle, 4 big spots, 3 small spots, and all the facial features including 2 horns, 2 ears, 2 eyes, and 1 muzzle. You'll also need polyester fiber fill and a tool to help with stuffing. Important notes before we begin. Make 1 head using your main color. 7 spots total get joined to the head. The horns get joined over 4 rounds from rounds 3 to 6. The ears get joined to round 8, with the last stitch of the last ear being joined as you start round 9. Crochet eyes get joined over 5 rounds from rounds 9 through 13. Or safety eyes get joined to round 11 just before starting the decrease rounds. Muzzle gets joined from round 13 onwards. There are 23 rounds total, ending with 18 stitches in the final round. Wrong side faces you as you crochet, and I can't stress how important this is for the join as you go. Again, wrong side means that the side facing you is the inside of the head, so that means the side that's not facing you is the right side or the outside of the head. Okay, now that we've got all these pieces done, we're ready to start the head. You want to have these ready and on the side because we'll be joining the horns, the ears, the eyes, or you can use safety eyes, the muzzle, and of course the last spots too. I'm just going to set these aside. Make sure the horns are closer to you because they're attached first. Start the head with the main color. I've mostly been using purple as my main color, but like the body, I'm going to work the head in orange, so you can clearly see which are the head stitches and which are the horn, muzzle, ear, or whatever other stitches used. Make a magic circle here and then work 6 single crochet into it. Once you've got 6 stitches, go ahead and close the magic circle and pull tight. Round 1 is now complete with 6 stitches. Now we're ready to start round 2, where we'll work 2 single crochet into each stitch around, and as we do so, carry this tail under the stitches to secure it tightly into place. So go ahead and work 2 single crochet into each stitch around now. Round 2 is now complete with a total of 12 stitches. Again, we are working with the wrong side facing us. Now that we've completed this round, we'll drop this tail here. Alrighty, we're ready to start round 3, which will see the joining of the first horn stitches spread over 4 rounds. For round 3, we'll single crochet 1 into 1 stitch, and then 2 into the following stitch. We'll repeat this around as we start to join to the horns. So single crochet 1 into the first stitch, and 2 into the next stitch. Mark the very first stitch of this round right here so we don't lose our placement. Work the rep again, single crochet 1 into this stitch, and then 2 into this next stitch here. Single crochet 1 into this next stitch. Now we'll start joining the first horn, so grab one horn. Start the join by putting the hook into the next head stitch here. We want to join to the second from last stitch made on the horn in the last round. So here's the tail. This was the last stitch made, so this is the second from last. Insert hook into the second from last stitch, so we sandwich these two layers on the hook. And work a single crochet right here. Remember to tighten. First stitch joined. Now we need an increase on the head here. So go into the same head stitch and join to the next stitch on the horn. Two layers on hook, work a single crochet right here. Increase made and first two horn stitches are joined to the head. And you'll notice that the pointed part of the horn points away from the stitch marker. That way. You know you've got it right when it points away. Again, we just worked an increase, so single crochet 1 into the next stitch, and then 2 into this stitch here. Do it again. Single crochet 1 into the next stitch, followed by 2 in this stitch here. Then single crochet 1 into this stitch here. Only one more increase left for this round, and we'll join them to the other horn. So insert hook into this head stitch and attach to the 8th from last stitch that was made. This is the first from last. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and here's the 8th from last stitch. Go up and over to keep from catching onto the fiber fill. Just stick your thumb in and down so you can get it in without grabbing the fiber fill. Two layers on hook, so single crochet them together here. Now work an increase on the head. So insert hook into the same head stitch and join to the next horn stitch here, the nearest one right after the last joined. Sandwich the two layers and single crochet them together. Round 3 is complete with 18 stitches total. And if we bring it up this way, you'll see the front of the head facing us. Notice how the horn tips face the exact same direction, so they're pointing forward. We're ready for round 4, so get the stitch marker out of the way for a second. For round 4, we'll work 2 single crochet, 1 into each stitch, an increase or 2 into the next, and we'll repeat this around 6 times as we join another stitch on each side of the horns. The first stitch will have us join to the horn. So go into this stitch here, Find the nearest available horn stitch and go right into it. Two layers on hook, work the first single crochet of the round right here. Mark this first stitch so we know where it is and we don't lose track. First stitch marked. Now work a single crochet into the next stitch, followed by an increase or two single crochet into this very next stitch. Now single crochet two, and work an increase into the next stitch, so two single crochet into one stitch. Now we'll join to the horn. But first, bring this tail into the head so it gets tucked into the head and out of the way. Insert hook into the next stitch on the head. Then go under, over, through the horn, under this stitch here, two layers, work a single crochet right here. Give the tail a little tug to pull it in more. Work one single crochet into the next stitch. Then work an increase in the next stitch here. Now we'll repeat all the stitches we've just worked on this side. So go into the next head stitch and join to the nearest available horn stitch on this other side. Work a single crochet around them together. Remember to pull tight. Single crochet one here, and then work an increase. Single crochet two, then work an increase right here. Now join to the horn. So insert hook into the next stitch on both so you've got two layers sandwiched, and work a single crochet right here. Single crochet one into the next stitch, and work an increase into the very last one. Round four is now complete, 24 stitches, and more stitches of the horn are nicely secured. All right, let's start round five, where we'll single crochet one into three stitches, single crochet two or increase into the next, and repeat this around six times as we continue to join the horns, and we'll also be attaching the very first spot for this head. Get the stitch marker out of the way for a moment. Start with a single crochet join to the horn. So go into the first stitch of the head, and then this time, rather than go in from the outside, right side to wrong side, go in from the wrong side to the right side. So hook goes in this direction instead. Notice the difference? And we'll work a single crochet right here. Doing it this way now, we'll press it flat down this way. Complete the stitch and place stitch marker into the first stitch so we know where it is. Now single crochet two over the next stitches. Then work an increase. Then single crochet four, one, two, three, and four. Now we need an increase in the last stitch made, but we also need to join to the horn. So go into the same head stitch, and again, go from the wrong side to the right side like so. So we're inserting this way as we join to the horn stitch. Yay, we've got that join and an increase here. Now single crochet 3. Increase or work 2 single crochet into this next stitch here. Now join this next stitch to the horn. Again, make sure you go from the wrong side of the horn to the right side, so it lays flat like this, and work a single crochet here. Okay, that side is joined. Now single crochet 2 over the next stitches. Work an increase into this next stitch here. Then single crochet 1 here. Let's attach a big spot. So grab the one with 12 stitches, and like we did for the body and limbs, place it right side to right side behind the work. Now single crochet join the next stitch to it so you've got 2 layers on your hook and you complete the single crochet here. Bring the tails into the head, then continue to attach 2 more spot stitches. Next stitches for both, 2 layers here, so it's the second join. Remember to keep it tight, then work into the third one here. Alright, we've got 3 stitches attached to the spot. Now we need an increase in the same head stitch. But as we do that, join to the horn stitch. Again, go from the wrong side to the right side, 2 layers on the hook. Work a single crochet right here, effectively making an increase at the same time. Now single crochet 3 over the next stitches. And work 2 single crochet into the very last stitch here. Round 5 is now complete with 30 stitches total, and you can see all of this is going very well. We're ready to begin round 8. Get rid of the stitch marker for a second so it's out of the way. Now for round 6, we'll join the remaining horn stitches to the head as we single crochet 4, followed by an increase and repeating this all the way around. Start by joining the first stitch of this round right here to this horn stitch. Again, go from the wrong side to the right side, but we see the tail is right here. We want to bring that in. So bring the tail into the head, then go into those stitches right here. Pull the tail tight and work the first single crochet. Remember to pull tight to secure it. First stitch is done, so place stitch marker into it now. From here, single crochet 3. Then work an increase here. followed by single crochet 4. Work 2 single crochet into this next stitch right here. Now we'll join the next 5 stitches of the head to the next 5 stitches of the horn. Go into the head stitch here. Remember, for the horn to go from the wrong side to the right side, through the nearest stitch, and we're attaching these next 5 stitches in this manner, so go ahead and single crochet 5 as you join the 2 layers together. Here we have 1. Remember to keep it nice and tight. We have 2. Keep it squished. And we have 3. And 4. And 5. Now we need an increase in this same head stitch as we join to the very last horn stitch right here. So single crochet here. The right horn has been fully attached. Now we can continue. Single crochet 4. And increase into the next stitch here. Join to the spot. Followed by single crochet 3. Join to the other side of the spot. Remember to pull tight. Now single crochet into the same head stitch again to create an increase right here. Now we'll join the last 5 stitches of this horn. So single crochet just like we did on the other side where we joined the 2 layers, like so, squishing them together. 1. Two. Three. Four. And 5. The left horn is joined. Now work an increase into the same last head stitch again. And this completes round 6 with a total of 36 stitches around. And here we can see how it's shaping up. Very nicely. We're ready to start round 7, so get the stitch marker out of the way for a second. Round 7 also has increases, but they are done slightly different, so we're just going to jump right into it. We're going to work 3 single crochet into the first 2 stitches. So single crochet 1, 2, and 3 into the first stitch. Place stitch marker into the very first stitch of the round so we know where it is. Now work 3 single crochet into the next stitch as well. So 1, 2, and 3. Now single crochet 1 into each of the next 16 stitches. And 16. Here we'll begin attaching a small spot. So insert hook into the next stitch and grab a small spot. Remember, it's the one with 8 stitches. Place it right side to the back of the work and insert hook into the first stitch and work a single crochet right here. Now pull the spot tails into the head. We need an increase in the same head stitch. So go into the same head stitch right here, and then into the next spot stitch right here, and work a single crochet here. Now work one more time into the same head stitch. So you get 3 single crochet into this stitch here. Now work 3 single crochet into the next stitch right here. From here, single crochet 4. Join to the spot. Followed by single crochet 3. And then join to the other side of the spot. Then single crochet 7 to complete the round. Round 7 is now complete with a total of 44 stitches. And here we can see how it's coming along. Okay, we're ready to start round 8, which will see the attachment of the ears. Now there are no increases or decreases in this round, so you'll just single crochet one into each stitch as we attach the ears and the spots. Remove the stitch marker to work a single crochet here. Then bring it back to mark the first stitch again. Now single crochet 16 more times, so we have 17 single crochet over the first stitches. You may like to count it out to make sure you've got them. Okay, so now we're ready to attach the right ear. Putting this down for just a second. Grabbing the first ear. Fold and press this flat edge together to create the curve. And we'll work along the straight side so it's ready. We'll work through 3 layers, so insert hook into the next stitch here. As we join the first ear, we want it so the open end is pointing to your right. We want to join to the last and first stitches of this ear. But we've got the tail here, so we're coming out of this for a second so we can lay the tail. Just lay this tail on top here so it gets tucked into the head as we work. So insert hook into this next stitch, then insert hook into this very last stitch made on the ear, and into the very first stitch that was made on the very last round of the ear, right here. So we've got 3 stitches. Now just rotate the ear downwards so the flat side is up. We've got these 3 layers on the hook. We've got the head and the 2 layers of the ear stitches. Now single crochet around them. Pull on this tail, sandwich them together, and work right here. Again, pull tight. And there we go! First stitch is attached, now we'll work 2 more. We'll work into the next round of the ears as they're joined to the next stitch here. Insert hook into the stitch, then go into the ears next round on each side. So right here along the edge, and then right here on the edge of the other side. So you've got 3 layers on the hook again. Sandwich them together and work a single crochet here. Again, remember, pull tight. Make sure it is nice and secure. Now work this one more time for the next round right here. Pull tight as you work a single crochet. Now we just have this magic circle tail hanging here, so we're going to weave it in to bring it down to where the last stitch was so we can bring it into the head. Now the first ear is attached and you can see it's right below the horn, so it's in perfect position. Now we'll single crochet one into the next stitch. Join to the spot here. Single crochet two. And join to the other side of the spot. Now single crochet seven across the next stitches. Make sure not to skip any accidentally. Join to this spot. Single crochet three. Join to the other side of the spot right here. Now single crochet five. Now we'll join the other ear. So insert hook into this next stitch right here and grab the second ear. Now this time, the open part of the ear has to point in the opposite direction, so to your left. This time we'll join to the second round. Remember, it's a four round ear, so here's four, three, and two is right here. So this is where the first stitches are joined. Though you may like to just quickly get the tail in first. So just weave this tail so it's closer to round two. Then pull it into the head. Insert hook into the next stitch. Again, you can count it out. Four, three, and two. So you're inserting into the second round on this side. Four, three, and two is right here. Again, sandwich this together and tighten it up. So tighten and complete the single crochet. Hook goes here, and into the second layer here, and into the third layer here. So we've got three layers on the hook, like so. And we work a single crochet here. This completes round eight, and you still have 44 stitches because we didn't increase or decrease. We still have an ear stitch left to attach, but it will be done as the first stitch for round nine. All right, we're ready to start round nine, which will see the finishing of securing the ear and the start of joining the crochet eyes. If using safety eyes, just single crochet one in place of each single crochet join for the crochet eye attachment. Remove the stitch marker to work the first stitch of the round to secure the ear. Go into this next stitch, then into the first stitch of the last round of the ear here, and into the last stitch of the round here. Secure as you single crochet around these stitches. You may have to twist and turn to get them through. Remember, pull tight. Complete the single crochet and then place the stitch marker into this first stitch of the round. Pull this tail into the head, then single crochet 4. Now both ears are secured. Let's take a quick look to see how it's coming together. Now we're ready to start attaching the eye. Now here's the trick for where the eyes go. You can follow the pattern and place the eyes like I do, or you can customize how you place them. It's very simple. Take your eyes and determine which side you'd like as the top. The left eye goes here. You need to pick 3 stitches, so place it here, rotate the eye around, and ask yourself which way you think looks best for your giraffe. Then when you've decided, oh, I like these 3 stitches for the top, you just flip it up, so you're pressing them right side to right side, and that's where you attach your eye. Now I already know where I want to position my eyes, so if you'd like to follow me, you can do that. Start by inserting hook into the next stitch on the head, and go into the 4th stitch made on the last round. So here was the first one, the second one, the third one, so this is the 4th stitch right here. Hook goes in and we single crochet them together right here. Then single crochet the next afterwards right here. And then the one right after it too, right here. So that secures the first 3 stitches of the eye to the giraffe. And here's roughly how it will look. Now we may continue. So single crochet 3 in between the eyes. Here's where we attach the other eye. Remember, if using safety eyes, to single crochet 3 here and do the same thing here. Right eye is joined the same way, just different stitches. So hooks in the next head stitch, and we'll join to the 7th eye stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Looks like a good spot. Of course, you can attach to whichever you like. If you're not sure, just flip it over. Then single crochet right here to join this stitch. And then into the next stitch here. Once more into this stitch. Again, just single crochet 3 if using safety eyes instead. Then we can just flip it over to see if we like how the eyes look. I think they look pretty good, don't you? Alright, we're happy with the eyes and we can continue. Now single crochet 7 over the next stitches. and 7. Here we'll join to the spot. Then single crochet 2. And join to the other side of the spot. Now single crochet 8. Here only 3 stitches of the spot are left, so we'll join them to these 3 stitches. So work through 2 layers and single crochet 3 as you complete this spot attachment right here. Make sure to go under the whole stitch. It helps to slip over and bring the hook down to get under it. Now single crochet 5. Here we'll attach a small spot. So insert hook into the next stitch, grab a small spot, put it to the back of the work, and insert hook into the second layer like normal, and single crochet attach the first stitch. Pull the tails in, and single crochet attach to the next stitch. Alright, attached. Now single crochet 1 into the last stitch right here. Round 9 is now complete, and again, no increases or decreases, so still 44 stitches in this round. Here we can see the head and face is shaping up nicely. Now we're ready for round 10, which is the final increase round of the head. Remove the stitch marker for the moment. Work 2 single crochet into each of the first 2 stitches. So 1 and 2 and then 1 and 2. Place stitch marker into the first stitch of the round. This will be our round tracker and rounds tracker because we need to count up the rounds too. Single crochet 2, 1 into each of the next 2 stitches. Now join the next stitch to this eye stitch. So go into this stitch and into this eye stitch right here, continuing to press them right side to right side for this round to give it a nice shaping on the top. And work a single crochet join here. Again, if following the safety eye method, just single crochet 1 here. Now single crochet 3 and join to the other side of the eye. Go in here and join to the right eye here, like so. Now single crochet one. Now repeat for the other eye. Go in here and join to this next eye stitch right here. Work the single crochet to join here. Then single crochet three. And join to the other side of the eye right here. Now single crochet seven. And seven. From here, there's only two spot stitches. So go ahead and single crochet join this first spot right here. But this is where we need an increase on the head. So go into the same stitch and cross over to this other spot stitch right here. Spot joined and increase made. Now work two single crochet into the following stitch. From here, single crochet 16 across the next stitches. And 16. Now join to the spot right here. Single crochet 2. And join to the other side of the spot for the last stitch of this round. Round 10 is complete with 48 stitches in the round. Take these tails and wrap them in so they're out of your way for future rounds. Now let's take a quick look to see what round 10 looks like. Okay, now we're ready to begin round 11, where we'll single crochet one into each stitch around, so 48 times, and as we do so, we'll secure the next stitches of the eyes and this spot over here. Leave this stitch marker here so we can mark the repeat rounds of single crochet 48. Start with single crochet 5, so work one single crochet into each of the next 5 stitches. If you like, you may mark the first stitch of this round. It's not needed, but it does help, especially since there are so many stitches in this round. Now single crochet this next stitch to the next eye stitch, but this time go in from the wrong side of the eye to the right side, so that way we start to bring the eye down. Remember to tighten as you pull the yarn through and complete the stitch. From here, single crochet 4 over the next stitches. Do the same thing as you join to the other side of the eye, going in from the wrong side to the right side, like so, and work a single crochet here. Now single crochet 1. Then we'll repeat the same stitches for the next eye. Remember, just to single crochet 1 in place of the joins if using safety eyes. Insert hook into the next stitch and into the next stitch on the eye. Make sure to just go into the stitch. Perfect! And complete the single crochet, or you just single crochet 1. Then single crochet 4. Join to the other side of the eye, going into the nearest available stitch. From here, single crochet 26 across the next stitches, once into each stitch. And 26. Join to the spot right here. Single crochet 2. And join to the other side of this spot for the last stitch right here. Round 11 is complete, again, 48 stitches. Now this is very important for those of you working with safety eyes. You need to mark stitches numbers 8 and 16. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You want to mark this stitch, and then 10, 12, 14, and this stitch right here. These two stitches are where you'll place the safety eyes later on, so go ahead and mark them now. Okay, we're ready to start round 12, where we'll continue to single crochet 48 around as we join to the eyes and the spots. Let's take the stitch marker out, and let's start with single crochet 5. Now you can put the stitch marker into the first stitch of the round. Join to the next available stitch on the eye, next stitch on the hook, and insert hook into the next eye stitch. And work a single crochet here. Again, if using safety eyes, just single crochet 1. Now single crochet 4. Join to the other side of the same eye. So insert hook in here. Come over to this stitch here. And single crochet here again, just single crochet 1 if using safety eyes. Single crochet 1 into the next stitch. And repeat eye stitches. Join these two stitch layers together here. Remember to tighten. Single crochet 4 across these stitches here. And then join to the other side of this eye over here. Again, wrong side to right side, then through the stitch, and tighten. Now pause here for a minute to take the eye tails and twirl them around so you can stuff the eyes. Since the next round closes the eye attachment. So push them right into the eyes to give them a bit of shaping. Just use your hook to bring up the stitches and continue to hide the tails. You should have 3 stitches. Here's 1, right? Then you've got 2 and 3 for this eye. Then do the same here. Just twirl it around. You don't have to twirl, but I find it helps to tuck them in better when I start with a twirl. And then you just stuff it in to give it a round shape to your eyes. You can see I'm pushing the tails in with the bottom end of my hook. You don't want to use the hook end, otherwise you'll never get them in because you'd end up pulling them in and out. Perfect. And again, 3 stitches are left on this eye. See 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's good to go and they're ready. Now we can continue with this round. Now single crochet 14 across the next stitches. From here, we'll attach another big spot, so insert hook into the next stitch, grab one of the big spots, and again, place it right side to the back of the work. You insert hook into the first stitch, and work the first single crochet attach. And remember, it's single crochet attach 3, so work 1, pull the tails in, and work it 2 more times. Remember, you're going through 2 layers of stitches here. Remember to pull tight. All right, 3 stitches are attached. Now single crochet 10. Ten. Here are 2 spot stitches that need to be joined to these 2 stitches here. So work 2 single crochet to join here. Then single crochet 1 into this last stitch right here. That completes round 12. Again, 48 stitches. And let's just take a look to see how our giraffe face is forming. Looking good, right? All right. We're ready to begin round 13, which will see the closing of these eyes, the joining of the spots, and now we'll add a third element, the muzzle. We'll start with some single crochet, but first remove the stitch marker for the moment, then single crochet 7. Now place the stitch marker into the first stitch again. Alright, here we'll join the next stitch to this first eye stitch, so we've got 2 layers. Safety eye users just single crochet 1. Now it's time to begin the muzzle attachment. The muzzle will be joined on the other side of these eyes, so we'll be working through 3 layers of stitches. First, go into the next head stitch, then into the eye stitch. Now we can grab the muzzle. Just set this down for a second. Here's the muzzle. Remember we marked the top 8 stitches and the bottom 7 stitches of the muzzle to help with attachment. We need to attach to the 8th from last, or stitch number 29, which is marked here. Count it out. 2, 4, 6, and what do you know, here's the 8th from last stitch. So insert hook into this stitch right here. Now that the hook is in the stitch, remove the stitch marker. Now see here the sandwich of three layers of stitches. If using safety eyes, you'll only have this layer and this layer. The middle layer will be gone. Otherwise, you have three layers. Squish them together, yarn over, pull through, pull tight to secure, then complete the single crochet. Repeat this for the last left eye stitch. Go into the next head stitch, into this last eye stitch right here, then into the next muzzle stitch. So again, three layers of stitches are on the hook, and you work a single crochet right here. The left eye is now completely secured. Now single crochet three, join the next stitches of the head and muzzle together. Insert hook into the next stitch on both, so you've got two layers on the hook, and work a single crochet right here. Do this two more times. So here and here, single crochet, and then here and here, single crochet. Excellent. Continuing on, take away this stitch marker since it is no longer needed. Now we'll finish securing the right eye and we'll do the sandwich thing again. So go through this stitch on the head, the first available stitch on the eye, and the next stitch on the muzzle. Again, three layers of stitches on the hook, and you work through all three, just like so. Repeat this over the next two stitches. So insert hook here and here and here, three layers on hook, work a single crochet. Repeat one more time. Hook goes here and into the last stitch of the eye here and into the next muzzle stitch here. Pull tight as you work a single crochet. Now we have 8 stitches of the muzzle attached. Count it out if you like. 2, 4, 6, and 8. So the top 8 stitches are now joined. We'll take a look when we finish the round. Let's continue with single crochet 15. All right, now single crochet join to the spot. Single crochet three. Join to the other side of the spot. And end this round with single crochet 12. Round 13 is complete. Again, 48 stitches. Now let's take a look and see how she's coming along. Here you can see the muzzle in place. Okay, we're ready to begin round 14. Again, we'll single crochet 48 around the head as we join to the muzzle and spot stitches. Remove the stitch marker and single crochet 6. Place the stitch marker back into the first stitch of the round. Now we'll join these two muzzle stitches to these two head stitches here. So press them together so they're still right side to right side. Hook goes into this stitch here, and into the second available stitch on the muzzle right here. Two layers on the hook, one stitch between the joins to spare, and single crochet these two stitches together. Now single crochet join this stitch to the loose stitch here. Two layers on the hook. Again, secure them with a single crochet right here. Now single crochet 8 over the next stitches. Next, single crochet the next two head stitches to these two muzzle stitches. Hook goes into the next stitch on both. Two layers here, and single crochet. Repeat, go into this stitch, and into this stitch, two layers again, and single crochet. More muzzle stitches have been joined. Now single crochet 13. Join to the spot again, just like we've been doing. Single crochet 3. And join to the other side of the spot here. Then finish this round with a single crochet 12. Round 14 is complete. Again, 48 stitches. It's coming along nicely. Let's begin round 15. Again, we'll single crochet 48, one into each, as we join more stitches. Take away the stitch marker and single crochet 6. Place the stitch marker into the first stitch. Now join to the muzzle. Again, go into this stitch here, then through the right side to the wrong side here, so it's like we're pressing them together. And single crochet join. Then single crochet 10. Join to the other side of the muzzle, insert hook in here, go into the right side to the wrong side of the muzzle, two layers on hook, and then you work a single crochet right here. Again, pull tight. Now single crochet 13. Join to the spot. Single crochet 3. And join to the other side of the spot. Now single crochet 5. Here we'll join another spot. So insert hook into the next stitch and grab a big spot, the one with 12 stitches. Place it right side to the back of work and insert hook into the very first stitch. Complete the first stitch, pull the threads in, and single crochet join 2 more times. Three stitches of this spot are now attached. Now single crochet 4 across the remaining stitches of this round. Round 15 is complete with 48 stitches again. Okay, we're ready for round 16, another single crochet 48 round with joining. Remove the stitch marker and start with single crochet 6. Mark the first stitch again. Join to the muzzle. Hook goes in here. Again, go right side to wrong side into the center of the muzzle and work a single crochet here. Now single crochet 10. And join to the other side of the muzzle. Again, right side to wrong side, like so, and single crochet here. Now single crochet 14. And 14. Here we have the last three stitches of this spot to join to the next three stitches. So work through two layers as you single crochet three across them together. Single crochet 5. Join to the spot. Single crochet 3. Join to the spot again. And then single crochet 3 across the remaining stitches. Round 16 is complete, again 48 stitches total. Now we're ready for round 17. Again, single crochet 1 into each stitch around as you join. Remove the stitch marker and single crochet 6. Mark the first stitch of the round. This is the last round we'll join to the muzzle this way, where we go in from the right side to the wrong side. Next round, we'll swap directions. Go ahead and single crochet here. Now single crochet 10. Now join the next two head stitches to the next two muzzle stitches. Why two? As odd as it seems, it aligns the muzzle to the slightly slanted head rounds better. So insert hook into this stitch here, go right side to wrong side here into this next stitch, single crochet one here. Then work into this next stitch here, and into this stitch here as well, single crochet. I know it seems uneven, but it actually looks much better done this way, which you'll get to see later. Now single crochet three. Now single crochet three, attach the final big spot. Insert hook into the next stitch here, grab the final big spot, insert hook into the first stitch, and work a single crochet here. Pull tails in and single crochet two through the next two layer sets of stitches. Three spot stitches attached, now single crochet 15. Single crochet join to the spot here. Single crochet three. Join to the other side of the spot. And single crochet three to complete the round. Round 16 done. As you can see, it's shaping up rather well. All right. We're ready for round 18, which is the final round of single crochet 1 into each stitch, so go ahead and start with single crochet 6. Mark the first stitch of this round. Now we'll join to the muzzle. Insert hook into the next stitch. This time, go through the wrong side to the right side and join the stitch right here. Single crochet 11 across the next stitches. Join the next stitch to the muzzle. Insert hook in here, again, wrong side to right side this time, and work a single crochet right here. single crochet 2, join to the spot right here, single crochet 3, and join to the other side of the spot here. Now single crochet 14, join to the spot here, single crochet 3, join to the other side of the spot here, and single crochet 3 to complete the round. Round 18 is complete, 48 stitches, and here's how she looks now. Okay, we've just finished the last repeat round. Now we'll be starting the decrease rounds and attaching the final spot to this head. If you are using safety eyes, place them into the stitches you marked in round 11 now. For round 19, we'll be decreasing by 6, so we'll single crochet 6, work a single crochet 2 tug, repeat a round, and we'll do this as we join to the muzzle and spots. Start with single crochet 2. Mark the first stitch of the round now. We'll attach the final spot here. Insert hook into the next stitch, grab the small spot, the one with 8 stitches, slip it on, right side to right side, and attach 2 stitches. All right, single crochet 2. Now we have 6 stitches, so the next will be a single crochet 2 tug using the invisible decrease, but this single crochet 2 tug gets joined to the muzzle. Get the back loops of the next 2 stitches onto the hook, like so, then insert hook into the next stitch on the muzzle, so you've got the 2 back loops and the next muzzle stitch on the hook. Single crochet them together. Now single crochet 6. I'm going to get rid of these other stitch markers since we don't really need them anymore and they're kind of in the way. Now work a single crochet two together. Again, back loops only. Now single crochet two. Join to the other side of the muzzle. Hook goes into here, this stitch, then into the next stitch on the muzzle. Both layers on hook and single crochet join. Remember to tighten. Single crochet two. Single crochet join to the spot. Now work a single crochet two together into the next stitches, so into the back loops only. Single crochet two. Then join to the other side of the spot right here. Single crochet three. Single crochet two together. Single crochet six. Single crochet two together. Single crochet one. Now join the last three stitches of this spot to these three stitches. So single crochet three through two layers of stitches to join them. Make sure you go into the whole stitch. Single crochet two. Then single crochet the last two stitches together. Round 19 is complete with a total of 42 stitches. Now we're ready for round 20, another decrease round where we'll single crochet 5, single crochet 2 stitches together, and we'll repeat this around 6 times, so we decrease by 6 stitches, and as we do so, we'll join to the muzzle and the spots. Move the stitch marker for a moment and start with single crochet one. Put the stitch marker into the first stitch right away. Then single crochet join to the spot. Single crochet two. And join to the other side of the spot right here. So far we have 5 single crochets. Now single crochet 2 together these 2 stitches, creating a decrease as we join to the next muzzle stitch. Go ahead and tuck this tail into the muzzle to get it out of the way. Insert hook into these 2 back loops on the head to create the decrease here. Then go into the next stitch on the muzzle, which is the first stitch of the last muzzle round. All layers on hook, work the single crochet 2 together right here. So you're decreasing on the head and joining to the muzzle at the same time. Single crochet 5 now. Work a single crochet 2 together right here. Now single crochet 2. Join to the other side of the muzzle. Hook goes into this stitch here, and into this stitch right here, and single crochet join them together. Then single crochet 2. Here, create a decrease on the head as you join to this spot stitch. Get the back loops onto the hook. Insert hook into this spot stitch here. Pull through, pull tight, and secure. Then single crochet 3. Join to the other side of the spot. You have to reach over to grab the stitch here, so stretch it over to this stitch here. Single crochet 1, then single crochet the next 2 stitches together. Single crochet 5. Single crochet the next 2 stitches together into the back loops only. Single crochet 5. And single crochet the last 2 stitches of the round together. Round 20 is complete with 36 stitches total. Now it's time for round 21, another decrease round. This time, single crochet 4, then single crochet 2 together, and repeat around as you join to the muzzle and to the spots. Remove the stitch marker, and start with 1 single crochet into the very first stitch. Mark first stitch placement, that way if you make a mistake, you can spot it faster. Single crochet join to this spot. Followed by single crochet two. We've got 4 stitches. Now we'll work a decrease as we join to the other side of the spot. So work a single crochet two tog. As you stretch around, grab the other side of the spot. There we go, decrease made. Now join the next stitch to the muzzle. Two layers on hook, work a single crochet right here. Now single crochet three. Single crochet two stitches together. Single crochet two. And join to the next muzzle stitch right here. Single crochet one, followed by a single crochet two together. We've got the last 3 stitches of this spot to join to these 3 stitches here. So go ahead and single crochet three as you work through 2 layers of stitches. Single crochet one, and then single crochet the next 2 stitches together. Now all we need to do is single crochet 4 and single crochet 2 together across the remainder of the round. So single crochet 4. Single crochet 2 together. Single crochet 4. And then single crochet the last 2 stitches together. Round 21 is complete with a total of 30 stitches. All right, we're ready to start round 22, where we'll single crochet 3, single crochet 2 together, repeat this around 6 times so we create a decrease of 6. Get the stitch marker out of the way for a minute. Start with single crochet 2, so 1 into each of the next 2 stitches. Mark the first stitch of the round so you know where it is. Here we've got the last spot stitches to join to the next stitches. So join the first one to the next stitch right here. Now we need a decrease on the head. So get the back loops of these 2 stitches on the hook. and scoot around to get under this last stitch of the spot right here. 3 stitches on the hook. Work through all of them to complete the join and decrease. Pull tight. There we go. Join the next head to the nearest muzzle stitch right here. Oops, didn't quite get it. It may be a bit cumbersome now, but just work slowly and you'll get it through. Remember to pull tight. Then single crochet 2. Then single crochet 2 together. Single crochet 3. Now work a single crochet 2 together as you join to the next muzzle. Get hook into the back loops of the next 2 stitches and then scoot around to get under the next stitch on the muzzle. So 2 layers on the hook and then you single crochet through these stitches. Single crochet 3. Single crochet 2 together. And repeat this 2 more times across the remaining stitches. So single crochet 3. Single crochet 2 stitches together. Single crochet 3 again. And single crochet the last 2 stitches together here. Round 22 is complete with a total of 24 stitches. We have one more round to go, but before we do it, we need to stuff the muzzle. So take hook out of the loop here and make the loop bigger for the moment, or you can put a safety pin or a marker to hold the loop. Now grab a bit of fiber fill, then use your fingers and a tool, get it nice and open and start to stuff it in. You may need to grab the muzzle end to stuff it in this way. Just fold it in, and if you need to, grab your tool to press it in further and push it into the front of the muzzle. Then just repeat that. So just push it in there. Again, use your tool to help push it forward. Twirl it around. This helps keep the fiber fill together and prevent strays. Take a look at your muzzle. If it's still a bit squishy, you may need a bit more. Just stuff until it is nice and firm. Going to stuff a little more and then I think it will be good. Again, use your hook or tool to get the loose strands tucked away. There you go. You want to be able to press these together, and I think that should do it. Now we can continue to round 23. Okay, we just finished stuffing the muzzle. Now we may begin the final round. For round 23, we'll single crochet 2, then single crochet 2 stitches together, and repeat around as we join to the last muzzle stitches. Start with single crochet 2. Put a marker into the first stitch so we know where it is. This also helps prevent errors. Work a single crochet 2 together here. Again, back loops of 2 stitches go onto the hook. Now we'll finish the join and close the muzzle. Single crochet these next 2 stitches to these 2 stitches on the muzzle. Important note, this next stitch on the head can sometimes be missed, so make sure you don't accidentally skip it. It has happened to me. So insert hook into the next stitch on the head, then into the next stitch on the muzzle, so you've got your 2 layers on the hook. Sandwich them together and work a single crochet right here. Pull tight. Do that again. Go into the next head stitch and into the next muzzle stitch, 2 layers on hook, and work a single crochet here. Skip this next available muzzle stitch. So skip this one and we'll work a single crochet 2 together on the head. So get the back loops of 2 stitches onto your hook. Remember, skip this muzzle stitch and go into the second available one right here. So these layers of stitches are on your hook and you complete the stitch right here. Now we'll skip the next muzzle stitch here and join the last 2 muzzle stitches to these 2 stitches here with single crochet. Hook goes into this stitch here, skip this one, and go over to this one right here. Work a single crochet. Then work a final single crochet join to the very last muzzle stitch here. Here you can see the muzzle has been joined completely and neatly. Now work a single crochet 2 together over these next 2 stitches. Keep everything nice and tight. Alright, single crochet 2. And then work a single crochet 2 together. Repeat this over the remaining stitches. So single crochet 2. Single crochet 2 together. Single crochet 2. And single crochet the last 2 stitches together. Take this stitch marker out of the way. Slip stitch into the first stitch of the round. You should have a total of 18 stitches. Fasten off, then proceed to stuff it. Okay, we've just completed the giraffe head. Now it's time to stuff it. It looks a bit wonky, but that's okay. The hole may seem a bit small, but you should be able to stuff it just fine. Have a tool at the ready to help you out. I'm just using a much larger hook. So grab a handful of fiberfill and then just start to get it in there. A repetitive motion helps. Just get a bunch in there, then you can use the tool to help spread it out. If it's too tricky to use your thumbs, just use your tool. Start pounding it in there and spreading it around. You want to really fill it out. Continue stuffing the head, and we'll meet back here when you're done. Okay, here you can see we've got the head nicely stuffed. Here's how it looks on each side, and here you can see the opening. And now you're ready for the final step. Hooray! Alright, now we have our two main pieces completed. We have the head with all its fancy things, and the body with its limbs. Now it's time to join them together. The very last stitch of both the head and the body should line up together, as you can see right here. To make sure these stitches get lined up perfectly, mark them with stitch markers. Basically for the head, stitches numbers 5 through 9 equals the front. So let's count them out. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here's the front. 6, 7, 8, 9. Here's the other side of the front. So these stitches here are the front, and they line up with stitches numbers 9 through 13 of the body. So let's count it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's see, does it match? It surely does. So we know they'll work out fine. So just make sure the very last stitch here is attached to the very last stitch on the head here. So they line up like so, and we'll start to join them here. Set the head down for a second. Now grab the long tail from the end of the body and thread it onto a tapestry needle or a yarn needle as you prefer. I like tapestry needles for better precision and definition. From here, we'll use the whip stitch to sew them together. Start by inserting needle up through the center of the last stitch, like so. Grab the head. Here we see the tail. Here's the last stitch that was made. Now go up through that stitch right here. So you're joining the last stitches of both together. So pull this through right here. Now you want the stitches to be secure. Watch out for the fiberfill. Try not to grab onto it. Go into here again, but go over to the next stitch on the head. The first one, where the slip stitch is. So you cross over on the inside. Leave the head tail out as we'll need it later. Cross over, and you'll need to pull tight once you've got it through. Do this every time. Now go into the next stitch on the body right here, from right side to wrong side, and go through that same head stitch we just came out of up top here. So each time you go into a stitch twice to really secure it. Once to secure it, and a second time to bring it over. Go back into the same bottom stitch and cross over to the very next stitch on the head over here. Try to avoid grabbing onto the fiberfill. Sometimes it's a bit tricky, but that's okay. So we're crossing over and remember to pull tight. Go down to the next stitch on the body and go back up into the head again. Remember, pull things nice and tight. Go back into the body and cross over to the next head stitch over here. You may have to fiddle around to get it through and avoid the fiber fill. Again, pull it tight. All right, we're rotating around. Go into the next body stitch right here, into the same stitch up here, and remember to pull it tight to secure it. Go in here, cross over to the next stitch, like so, pull tight. We're coming to the front. This bit is more challenging with the muzzle in the way. Go into the next body stitch here, very carefully, and go back up into the same head stitch up top here. Back into the same body, cross over to the new head. Just push things to manipulate them where needed. And just repeat this around. So go into the next body down here, up into the same head up here. Just get it in. Oopsie-daisy, we don't want this. Pull it in. Cross over here. You have to push the needle so it doesn't go into the wrong place. And sometimes it gets caught on the arm, as you can see it's doing an awful lot to me. All right, we're right under the muzzle, so it's a bit more tricky. Go into the new body and into the same head. Just manipulate the muzzle and get your thumb under here to direct where you need it to go. And now it's getting caught on the leg. It's not very cooperative, but I guess that's okay. Remember, pull it nice and tight to secure. Again, go into the body and into the next head stitch up here. Just kind of angle it so you get it through. Pull tightly. Into the next body here. Back up into the same head over here. And secure it nice and tight. Back into the same body. Cross over. And you just want to repeat this process all the way around. Just push those strays out of the way. Now we're getting away from the muzzle, so it should be a little bit easier to work. Its floppiness makes it a bit challenging too, but you can do it. Nice and secure. It helps to make the giraffe sit as you work. We're coming along nicely here. Just keep rotating him around. Okay, once you get to this point with only a few more stitches to go, you may like to add a little more fiber frill to make sure that the neck is really full and firm. So grab a little bit of filling and just get it in there. Push it up into the head, push it into the neck, push it forward, and this helps to really brace the head. Pushing it up seems to be easier than pushing it down. Go ahead and use your tool as needed to even it out. Just going to put a little bit more. This seems pretty good to me. It's bulging a bit, that's cool. And now we'll get back to sewing. Remember to tighten. Go into the next stitch and back up to the same one here. Into the same one down here and a new one over here. Just keep repeating this to close it up. If you get the right angle, you don't grab the fiber fill, which is the ideal. We're on the last stitches here. Secure everything very neatly. Just like this. And we're back to the first stitch where we started. We just want to secure it here. All right, head is now firmly attached to the body. Now tie these two tails together here. Make a little knot, a double knot if you will. Then weave these final tails into the body using your needle. Poke into wherever you can hide the knot better. In my case, it's here, going down. Pull it through. Go back in. Weave it in and out of the project to hide the ends. Just go in and out wherever you like. Then do the same for the other tail. Make sure you go through the same stitch as the first tail so the knot gets pulled deeper into the work. Now the knot is less visible. Weave this end in and around the body here as much as you like. When you're done, just trim the ends and tuck it in with the end of the needle. And here we have our giraffe completely worked. I'm just going to straighten these out. I'm just trimming the tail ends. You can tweak yours too if needed. Here you can see two giraffes together. The larger one, we did our tutorial together with her. She was worked by me tripling up on my thread, which equals roughly a sport weight yarn. And this little guy, my original, was worked with my cotton thread size 10, just the one time. So we've got two fun sizes, the same pattern, the exact same stitching, and they both came out absolutely adorable. I hope you've enjoyed crocheting Otis Giraffe. Get support and support me by joining the various events and groups across my social channels. Share your completed giraffes there and make new friends too. Hashtag Otis Giraffe Cal when you share to let us know you crocheted with us. Tag me at my user at Becca's Treasures on Instagram and Twitter so I can see you there too. Finally, find the written pattern in multiple languages for this part via my blog at www.rebeccastreasures.com/blog. Thanks for watching part 6, How to Crochet the Head and Work the Finishing Touches for the Otis Giraffe Crochet Along. Congratulations! You now have an outstanding giraffe to call your own or gift. Did you have fun learning new amigurumi techniques? Share your experience with us and tell us what you'd like to crochet next. Likes, comments, and shares help my channel to grow. Thank you. Would you like to see more? Subscribe to my channel to be notified when a new tutorial comes along. Thank you again for tuning in to Rebecca's Treasures. Have a wonderful day.